10 minutes. Okay, guys. Good afternoon. Welcome back to Political Science class. Okay, so in the morning session we started a new lesson, that is development. Thank you from our political theory. So we know that this is not that much difficult to understand. The things are not difficult to understand. What we can say? A deep reading is necessary. Clear or not? Okay, so want to read and analyze the things that properly. Okay, so we will start. Right in the textbook here. So in the last class, we introduced the chapter and we discussed up to here, I think, right? Okay, clear, after that completed. So we know that not only economic development, so all around development is a necessary thing for the development of a country. Not only economy, not only people's standard of living, but the society want to upgrade it. Clear. People want to enjoy their freedom. People want to enjoy equality in the society. Okay. People basically want to lead a secured life in the society. Clear. Wealth is there, but there is no security for life. What is that? Okay. Wealth is there, the people are unable to enjoy their freedom. What is that? No use with that, right? So that kind of development also necessary for an all around development. Issues such as whether the rights of people have been respected in the course of development. Clear or not? So we achieved development, but the rights of the people are protected or not, or respected or not. That is the question here. The rights of the people. Clear? So we studied about America, right? A country that is well developed, well maintained, a good administrative system, and they are the world police, sophisticated weaponry. Okay, so many things are there for the country. But last year, one person died in that country. Okay, he became the prey of racial discrimination. Clear? Clear? The American police killed an individual there, a black man. Clear or not? So where is the freedom for the people? Where is the respect for the people? Yes, the country achieved development. Okay, economically well developed country. Okay, first class military forces there for their country. Economically, technologically, okay, everywhere development is visible in that country. But there is no freedom for the people. No use of such kind of development. Whether the benefits and burdens of development have been justly distributed. Okay, at the same time, the country, in a country, the burden for development, it should be equally distributed. Everyone want to work for the development, not only the poor people. Basically, the government is collecting taxes. You know that? Various types of taxes are there. Basically, who are paying these taxes? Who are paying these taxes? The common man, they are paying the taxes, right? Right? By purchasing petrol. By purchasing diesel. By purchasing grocery products from the shops, grocery shops, we are paying taxes. And the wealthy people, okay, it's basically Vijay and Dinesh from our near state, that is neighboring state, Tamil Nadu. Okay, so they purchased the crores of, so the cars, the worth rupees crores, right or not? Basically, I think the Rolls Royce cars there, right? Okay, but they pleaded, they come, book, sorry. Okay. They pleaded for the court that they have some relaxation on these taxes. They are not ready to pay this entire taxes. All right? Yes or no? So court asked that people, the film starts. Why? What is the question, you know? The common people regularly they are purchasing the petrol in our country and they're paying huge taxes to the government. And you people are rich. Okay. You can do that. You pay it. Okay. So that's it. Okay. Clear. Or whether decisions regarding development priorities have been democratically made. Or we want to discuss the decisions that are taken by the government is democratically made or not. So, number of programs and policies are there for the government. Okay. Sometimes the government will take this, these decisions without the consultation with the people, right? Clear on, they themselves will take the decision. But such kind of decisions are not good. For a social development, basically the government want to discuss with the people and want to give priority, importance for the ideas of people there. Development goals for the people. Okay, democratically made, have been raised in many countries, hence development has become the subject of considerable controversy today. So there's a number of controversies are related with development. Number of controversies are there. Whatever may be the plan, two arguments will be there. One argument that is supporting the plan, other argument basically opposing the plan, right? Everywhere, whatever it may be, which is a good plan or bad plan or the worst plan ever, there will be two dialogues. Two sides are there. Two comments will be there. One is to support that, another is to oppose that. The models of development which have been adopted in different countries have become the subject of debate, and criticism and alternative models have been put forward. In such a situation, the broader understanding of development can serve as a standard by which the development experience of a country is examined. So the development experience of a country, we can examine, we can observe that, we can study about that. In what ways? Again, broader understanding of development can serve as a standard by which the development experience. Okay. So different countries using different methods. So some models are standard models. Clear? Clear or not? Some methods are basically used by someone. We are simply copying that, or we are simply following that. Okay. But some countries are moving forward with the numerous new plans and programs for the overall development of the people. Okay. So you can see the models of development which have been adopted in different countries have become the subject of debate. We have to discuss about that. Sometimes you have to criticize it. Criticisms that necessary. Whatever may be the plan, we can support it the same time, we can oppose also. Example, the Adripilli power project. Adripilli. No, where is Adripilli? That is in our district, right? So, clear? Right. And what is the speciality? The area with the scenic beauty, right? Scenic beauty. Okay. And the government proposed a plan there. Constructing a hydro power plant there. Okay. Clear or not? Constructing a dam in that region. Clear. Is that good or not? What is your opinion? Constructing a dam in Adripilli by destructing its scenic beauty, is that good or bad? At the same time, acres of the forest land will submerge under the water also. Okay, tell me now, what is your answer? It is good or bad? It's an issue of debate. It's a development activity of the government only. Okay, myself, I asked a question to you people. Are you supporting this plan or not? Okay, so if the plan come to be a success, number of people, basically our industries can use electricity from that particular project. Okay, clear or not? Clear or not? But at the same time, it will create a problem for the people in that locality too. And the scenic beauty will destruct and they okay. Are you supporting or opposing? No answers from you. Abhijit Aram, what is your answer? Abhijit Aram.
Excuse me, sir. Can you repeat again?
That's what. Okay. Are you supporting the project or opposing the project? Are you fully damn project?
Opposing, sir.
Why it is so?
Sir, your voice is not clear. Can you put in the chat? My net is slow.
And if you are sending all these questions in the chat box, it will take centuries to complete this class. Okay. Just tell me fast. Okay, Abhijit, I will give you a chance for you later. Sanam Jose, what is your opinion?
Sir, it is good and bad in a way. It's good for development. But
my
then
question,
again,
what is your opinion?
Sir, that is my opinion, sir.
This is your opinion.
No, sir, I can't really say that. No.
Sir. Can I leave and rejoin? It is not clear. Your question.
Okay, fine. So Sanand Jose says like a diplomatic one. So diplomatic one in the sense, not this. You do that, but some problem is there. But this is better than that. Sometimes that is better than this. It's called a bit diplomacy. Understanding or not. Okay. So let it be. Some people are there with that opinion also. Okay. So they will say that, okay, this plan is good, but at the same time, it will create problem for the people. We have to solve that issue first. Okay. Then we can start the program. That is a good approach only. Okay. I'm not against that. Okay. Good approach only. What about Abhilash?
There are developmental benefits, but in hindsight, I oppose with the plan because if the project didn't go as well as it was originally planned, then it is like unnecessary destruction of flora and fauna and a very good tourist destination. And then nothing will be there at the end if the project isn't successful.
Okay, fine. So that's a correct one. Okay, if it is goes wrong, a total chaos will be there. Total trouble will be there, right? Okay, clear or not? Kevin, what happened? Where were you?
Sir, Kevin, I don't know. My device just went off. Let's rejoin.
Okay, okay. So that's it. That's it. So that's the fine answer. Okay. So there are numerous problems are there, but at the same time, the people, those who are rejecting this program, gave alternative plans for the government. Nothing but so they told the government to purchase LED bulbs instead of this incandescent bulb and give those bulbs to the people in large numbers. So we can save the electricity almost equal to the proposed plan. Okay, clear or not? Understanding or not? So it's an alternative plan, right or not? So government did it, I think so. Okay, so government allotted or provided this ICFL lamps and LED bulbs for numerous families there. Okay, to save energy. To save energy. Clear. Example, that plan is just 24 megawatt means. Okay, equal to that amount, if you are purchasing and providing that LED bulbs to the people, we can save the same amount. So we can protect the nature, right or not? Right or not? So that's an alternative plan. So if you are rejecting one plan, you should come forward with an alternative plan. Alternative plan, for example, I told you. So easily we are able to understand the development of a country by observing the developmental plans and programs that are adopted from adopted by that particular country. Okay, not only economic development, but social development by providing respect, freedom, equality. Okay, next one. The challenge of development. Challenge of development. What are the challenges basically facing by the idea of development? The concept of development gained importance after the second half of the 20th century. This was time when the large number of countries in Asia and Africa gained political independence. Okay, so we know that after the Second World War, numerous countries in Asia and Africa, they got independence. Okay, example, India. India, we got independence in the year 1947, soon after the Second World War. Second World War. Second World War ended in 1945. Okay, it's a furious war between 1939 and 1945. And we got independence in 1947 after the Second World War. Not only India, numerous countries in the world, basically from Africa and Asia, they become independent or they okay become independent countries. Okay, so the idea of development is become popular after the Second World War. Okay, almost all the countries, the newly independent countries, they started thinking about development, what to do to achieve development. Almost all these countries have started thinking that. Most were impoverished and their population had a low standard of living, education, health and other facilities were poor. They were often described as underdeveloped or developing. The comparison was with the richer countries in Western Europe and the United States. Okay, clear? So number of these Asian and African countries, they faced lots of problem at the beginning. Okay, or the beginning stage of their independence. Clear? Or soon after independence. What did that? Poverty. There is no good health facilities available in the country. Education standard is low. Okay, clear or not? Food production is low. There is no good military for the country. Okay, everywhere these countries face lots of problems there. Okay, and the entire world, other countries grouped these countries as underdeveloped countries or developing countries. Underdeveloped countries or developing countries. And they used a model. What is that? United States of America and West European countries, not all European countries are rich. The West European countries are rich. Eastern one facing lots of problem. Eastern European countries facing lots of problem. Okay, so Western European countries. Clear? That is the model. So everyone want to achieve development like that. Development like that. Are you thinking America is a rich country without beggars? Without homeless people? A thing like that? No. Okay. There also such problems are there. Okay, but we people basically see or observe the filmed America, right or not? Superman, Spider-Man, that man, this man, this girl, that girl, that woman, this woman. Okay, in such movies, there is no or nothing related with the poverty of that country, right or not? Every time they will show about the or glorify the development, but really it is not. Okay. There are also these homeless people are there. There are also beggars are there, right or not? Are there. Some movies we can see that. Okay. But they will not show that. But in Indian movie, basically, we'll give focus to that problem, right or not? Poverty, impoverishment, okay. Religious fights, those kind of things. That's what the main thing they're doing. Priority to fill in. Okay, let it be. Come back. So all these countries, they used America and West European countries as their model. And they started thinking, we want to achieve that sort of development. Okay, we want to convert that our country into America. So most of the chief ministers will say that we will create a mini Singapore. We will convert Andhra Pradesh into a mini Singapore. We will convert that particular state into a mini Singapore. So their developmental goal is what? Their model is what? Singapore is the model. Singapore is the model. Like that. So what is special to Singapore ever visited? Anyone? No. Okay. Singapore. What is speciality? It's a developed country. All right. Developed one. Clear or not? Okay. Number of Indians are working in Singapore. What is the currency of Singapore?
Sri Lankan dollar?
Yeah. Not Sri Lankan. Singapore dollar.
Singapore dollar.
Correct answer. Okay. So that's what Kevin Goshi told about Sri Lanka. Sorry. Singapore dollar. Sri Lanka. Okay. Singapore dollar. Correct answer. Singapore dollar. Correct answer. Okay. Next one. Okay. I think this idea is clear for you, right? So newly developed or newly independent countries after the Second World War, they used America or West Asian countries, West European countries as their model. In 1950s and 1960s, when most countries of Asia and Africa had achieved independence from colonial rule, the most urgent task in front of them was to solve the pressing problem of poverty. So number of Asian African countries, they got independence after the Second World War. And the first problem all these countries faced is nothing but eradicate poverty. Or solve the problem of poverty. It was a pressing concern or pressing issue for almost all these countries. Clear? Almost all these countries faced that problem, alone. Poverty. Clear or not? The people in poverty. Poor generation, poor people they are. Okay. Malnourishment. Second problem. What is that? Malnourishment. What do you mean malnourishment? Malnourishment. What is that? Malnutrition or malnourishment means?
Sir, failure of maintaining one's body and having a very poor health condition.
Definitely. Okay. There is no perfect food intake. The diet is not balanced. No nourishment for that body. Okay. So called be malnourishment. A condition, basically, he's alive, but a number of diseases. Okay. Related with the absence of food. Absence of a proper food. For proper diet, clear. Malnourishment and unemployment. Unemployment, a situation where there is no job for the people. Okay, they are unable to generate income. That's what unemployment, illiteracy. Okay, lack of education and lack of basic amenities. Okay, what are the basic amenities? Food, shelter, clothing. So all together basic amenities. And the majority of their population face. So majority of the population of these newly independent countries face these problems. One is poverty. Second one is malnourishment. Third one is unemployment. Fourth one is illiteracy and lack of basic amenities. Okay, lack of basic amenities are the basic problem that faced by many people from different countries that are newly independent. They argued that the reason why they were backward was because under colonial rule, their resources had been used not for their own benefit, but for the benefit of their colonial masters. Okay, so we will say that the British has looted our wealth, right? Yes or no? Is that correct or not? We're going to Buckingham Palace in England, okay, the official palace of the Queen or the Emperor of Britain or United Kingdom. There are more than 700 bedrooms are there in that palace. Almost all these rooms are decorated with Indian take, Indian hammer, Indian ivory, right? Okay, that kind of decorative works are there. Okay, the Queen's crown is studded with a Kohinoor diamond that's from India, right? Kohinoor diamond. Okay, the peacock throne of the Mughal emperors, right? Clear or not? Almost, basically the enemy of British people, Tipu Sultan, even his sword also in the British museum. clear or not in the British Museum. Understand? Even the person who fought against the British people, Mahatma Gandhi, okay, clear or not? His spectacles and his chapel once it was in the British Museum. Clear or not? And one person who purchased that, basically speaking, so in an auction, okay, in a bidding, that is Vijay Mallya, a liquor baron. Okay, irony. Clear or not? Let it be. So that's what they looted our wealth, we can say. They ruled our country, but at the same time, they exploited our wealth. These British people, they exploited our wealth. Clear? Clear or not? So, like that, number of these Asian and African countries, once it was under the, or those countries were under the control of this colonial powers. Colonial powers, and these colonial powers looted the wealth of these countries and used for the development of their mother country or their motherland, not that particular country. So, wealth from India, the British ruled India. At that time, they looted the wealth from India, right? But they used that wealth for the development of their motherland, not India. Not India. Clear or not? They're clear or not? So that was the complaint that rose by number of these newly developed countries. What is that? What was that? Okay, all their wealth basically looted by the colonial masters, colonial countries. With independence, they could recognize their resources in the best possible manner to serve their national interest. So after independence, they decided they will use the resources that are available in their country for the development of their own country, their own motherland, their own motherland. So you know that up to 2020, there's only one country that is famous for the export of diamonds. It is South Africa, right or not? South Africa, diamonds. Okay, so that much diamond is from that country, but that country is not that developed. Why? Why? Okay. The colonial people, they looted this, basically. Clear? Not the indigenous people of that country. Okay. So therefore, it was no possible for them to formulate such policies which would allow them to overcome their backwardness and move forward achieving the standard of their former colonial masters. Okay. So the newly independent countries, they decided they will create a development plan for their own country and try to overcome the development of their colonial masters. Okay. Clear or not? They will try to overcome their colonial masters, it seems. This provided the impetus for these countries to undertake development projects. This gave more courage or more strength to these countries to start new development projects to achieve development. Okay, hope this much clear for you people. Okay, these ideas are clear or not? So yes, my question sir. Question is, reading textbook, I know this is a little bit boring for you people. But it is important for the examination too. Because our examination, first time it is MCQ, right? So reading is compulsory. We are unable to escape from that. Clear? I know that most of you people are not interested to read these chapters in form. At least read this in class. Okay. So I will give 2 minutes. Please do that. The concept of development has undergone many changes over the years. Initially, the focus was on catching up with the West in terms of economic growth and the modernization of societies. Developing countries adopted goals like faster economic growth through industrialization, modernization of agriculture, and extending and modernizing education. It was believed at the time that the state was the only agency capable of initiating this kind of social and economic change. Many countries embarked upon ambitious projects of development, often with the help of loans and aid from developed countries. Okay, so almost all these countries in the initial stage, they give more importance for economical development. They have to catch up or they have to reach closer to the developed countries. Okay, clear or not? So they made numerous plans and programs to do so. Okay, and a number of development goals also. Okay, for faster economic developments called to be industrialization and modernization of agriculture. Number of modern industries were erected or started by these governments, different governments. At the same time, they supported the agriculture production, modernized the agriculture production. But you studied about the green revolution, white revolution, gray revolution, okay, blue revolution in India, basically improving the agricultural production. The same time, give more importance for starting numerous industries also, numerous industries. And basically, almost all this program, in a view that to achieve the economic development, and started numerous programs, construction of dams, roads, railways, with the support of the developed countries and with the foreign aid. I mean, sorry, that's what the foreign union, help from the foreign country itself. At the same time, they took loans from different international organizations, like International Monetary Fund, World Bank, right? Numerous countries did the same. In India, a series of five-year plans for development were made starting from the 1950s. And these include a number of mega projects such as the Bakranagar Dam, underlined, setting up of steel plants in different parts of the country, mining, fertilizer production, and improving agricultural techniques. So India, I already told you that. Okay, numerous projects, construction of dams. Okay, that's called with the mega projects. Okay, basically related with the, you can see here, the Bakranagar Dam. Bakranagar Dam, it's a major project, major projects. Clear? Okay, setting up of steel plants in different parts of the country, mining, fertilizer production, and improving agricultural techniques. Improving agricultural techniques. Clear? Understand? So basically, that's a concept. Only government want to do this kind of mega projects. Clear? Basically, you can see here, a dam, no private people. Steel plants, private people can do that, and the center government does interfere in that. Mining, fertilizer production. So all these things to improve the agricultural production, industrial production, and use the agriculture, new agriculture techniques to improve agriculture production. It was hoped that a multi-pronged strategy would have an impact on the economy and significantly increase the wealth of the country. So they decided and they believed that this kind of development definitely will help the economic development of the country. It was also hoped that the emerging prosperity would gradually trickle down to the poorest sections of society and have to reduce inequality. So they believed that this kind of development will reduce poverty in the country by improving the standard of living of the poor people. A great deal of faith was placed in adopting the latest discoveries of science and state, of all the art and technology. New education institutions like the Indian Institute of Technology were set up. Okay, so read up to here. So number of new institutions were started by the government to support development. Read it first. Okay, so number of educational institutions, numerous plans for development. Okay, so we know that not only economic development, we need a social development also. So education is playing a vital role in that. Okay, so and basically all these things started with the collaboration with the advanced developed countries. Okay, in order to have access to their knowledge become top priority, it was believed that the process of development would make the society more modern and forward looking and set it in the path of growth. However, the model of development adopted by India and other countries has become under the great deal of criticism over the years, and this has led to some rethinking about the goals and processes of development today. So anyway, all these programs that adopted by the government is to develop the country, right? But today, the developmental goals of India and almost all the Asian and African countries is undergoing criticism. Clear or not? People are criticizing these plans there, and now all these governments are rethinking. Okay, clear or not? And rescheduling the programs. Clear? So this is enough for today. What we discussed today, only 3 students are present. I mean, nearly 6 are absent. Okay. So remember, the things that what we discussed is not that difficult. You read the textbook. Okay. And Abhilash, please send me a message related with the notes there. Okay, any chapter's notes are pending, just inform me. I'll send that to you. Okay, so notes are available in the school website also. Clear? If you want any chapter's notes, please inform me. I will send that to you people. Anyway, now an exam is there before that you have to start the revisions. So I want to send these notes for you people. Any chapter's notes pending? So if it is so, please inform me. I will send the notes for you. Anything else?
No.
Okay. Okay, so please read the textbook. We will give the next session on Thursday. Clear? Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.